Hey, so it's good to see you guys again. I know I haven't really done anything lately, especially after that little debacle on Facebook, mainly because I've been working more than usual and, you know, just doing stuff to keep the time going so that I don't feel it going too slow, because I'm waiting for July. And at this point, I think I'm really, really close to officially applying for my visa. Just waiting for the results of my test that I took last Wednesday. Should be here early next week, together with the documents that Joseph sent me. So, it should be fine. Today, I'm not going to talk about just one topic. I'm going to talk about a few things that are on my mind or is going on around the world. First of all, I'm not supposed to be smiling, but today's May 21st, because it's like 2 in the morning and I'm not asleep yet. I'm awake because I've been planning this little thing for a while. For a while. Breaking news. At about 1:30-ish, or just about half an hour ago, Superhero Hype posted a link on Facebook from TMZ.com announcing that Macho Man Randy Savage is dead. It's just shocking, because it's not like Michael Douglas, where you hear that he's battling terminal cancer and then he dies, he's not dead yet, but you expect it. So I clicked on the TMZ link, and it is confirmed by Macho Man's brother. His name is Lanny Poffo. He suffered a heart attack while driving, and then he lost control of his car, veered into oncoming traffic, and tried to swerve or, you know, avoid cars, and ended up hitting a tree smack head on, and that killed him. I don't know, apparently it didn't instantly kill him. He was brought to a hospital, and he was sitting with his wife Lynn Payne. You know, even though he's not one of the wrestlers that were my favorite, it's still sad to find out that, you know, death is never easy. Death is never something you can be indifferent about, no matter how you feel about that person. It just takes a bit of sinking in, depending on how close you are to that person. He was a major player in wrestling, and that's something anyone can respect, no matter if you idolize that guy or not. So 2 months ago in March, one of my favorite bands, Protest the Hero, released a new album called Scurrilous, and I listened to it. I got the entire album, I listened to it, and I have to say I'm not liking it. Because, okay, here's to people who have never heard of them. This is how their sound evolved. This is called Fear and Loathing in Laramie. And then in 2005, 2 years after that, they released a full-length album called Kezia. And it spawned a track known as Heretics and Killers. And then 3 years after that, they released an album called Fortress. Now this is flat out major release, and every single track was awesome. I loved it to death. For instance, if you thought that was awesome, or if you thought that was lame, I'll let you listen to the chorus. And then the outro. And then there was another song that automatically became my favorite. It's called Sequoia Throne. I'll let you listen to a really nice part. And then Scurrilous came out.